In 1947, amidst a backdrop of post-war disillusionment and distrust in the media, the Commission on the Freedom of the Press, also known as the Hutchings Commission, delivered a groundbreaking report that would reshape the landscape of media governance. Led by Robert Hutchins, a revered scholar and president of the University of Chicago, the commission brought together 12 esteemed experts to tackle the pressing issues surrounding media freedom and responsibility. At the heart of their deliberation was a fundamental question: is the freedom of press in danger? The commission's answer was an unequivocal yes. They identified three key reasons for this perilous state of affairs. First, they noted the growing importance of the press as a mass communication tool, which paradoxically reduced the ability of ordinary citizens to express their opinions. Second, they criticized the inadequacy of the service provided by those who control the media machinery. And finally, they condemned the unethical practices that had tainted the industry, eroding public trust and confidence. While the commission acknowledged the noble ideals of the Fourth Estate model, they cautioned against the blind pursuit of freedom without accountability. The unrestricted freedom of the press, they argued, had enabled media professionals to abuse their power, undermining the very principles they were meant to uphold. In response, the commission proposed a new paradigm, a social responsibility model of media governance. At its core was the principle of responsibility to society, a recognition that the media organizations had a duty to serve public interest. This marked a significant departure from the laissez-faire approach of the free media model. Under the social responsibility model, government interference was not outright rejected, but was instead tempered by a system of professional ethics and peer review. Media professionals were expected to adhere to a code of conduct that prioritized accuracy, fairness, and transparency, with independent bodies tasked with adjudicating ethical disputes. While initially met with skepticism from within the media establishment, the social responsibility model soon gained traction, becoming the predominant framework for media governance in many countries. Over time, it continued to evolve as scholars, professionals, and policymakers refined its principles and practices. Today, as we reflect on the legacy of Hutchins Commission and the birth of the social responsibility model, we are reminded of the enduring importance of media ethics in our increasingly interconnected world. By upholding the values of integrity, accountability, and public service, we can ensure that the media remains a force for good in society, empowering citizens, fostering dialogue, and safeguarding democracy. Join us in the next part of our series as we explore the ongoing challenges and opportunities facing media governance in the digital age. Until then, remember that with freedom comes responsibility, and with responsibility comes the power to shape a better world. Thank you for watching.